Chris Stevenson and Terry Koshin of the QMI agency here in Ufa, Russia, where we watched Canada lose a resounding 5-1 decision to the Americans today. Terry, Canada will now not be where they want to be on Saturday, and that's playing in the bronze medal game against Russia. What did you take away from that game against the Americans today?
Well, it's one of those hard ones to figure out. I think the coaching staff is going to be losing a lot of sleep for the next few nights, not just Thursday night, Chris, over the way the Canadians lost. It'd be one thing if you had a hard-fought game and you lost 3-2 in overtime or a shootout, and you could look yourself in the mirror and say, we gave it everything we had. But yeah, the Canadians can't do that. And that's pretty scary. And in such a big game like that, and you know, the fact that they had built nicely through the preliminary round meant nothing. And you gotta give a lot of credit to the Americans. As much as the Canadians were flat and emotionless, a lot of that had to do with the way the Americans were playing. A hard forecheck, sound defensively, and when the Canadians did break through, John Gibson was there. So yeah, not where they want to be, but I guess, hey, they get to play Russia in a game that means something.
It was two teams really that were playing a completely different game today. I mean, yeah, the pace of the American game, I mean, the Canadians just couldn't keep up, you know.
No,
we were talking about it before. Canada couldn't make like two passes in a row in that mm-hmm. in that first period. There were turnovers all over, and of course when you keep turning the puck over in the neutral zone, you don't have the opportunity to get the forecheck going, which is, you know, the hallmark of Canada's game. What
yep.
Canada wanted to do, the Americans did to them. You know, and people are going to come back to, I want your thought on this too, people are going to come back to Malcolm Subban. I've seen on Twitter and comments that we just saw in the chat that we did about, you know, Malcolm Subban's to blame. And I mean, this was a collective yeah. effort. I mean, the first two goals, I don't think he even saw the shots. The Canadian defense didn't clear anybody out from in front of the net on the first two American goals. Who do you have? You know, if there's going to be responsibility, who do you hang this one on?
No, it goes to everybody. I mean, yeah, Subban didn't stop the pucks when they were coming at him, but the fact is he had zero support in front of him. And to hang this on the goaltending, do it if you want, but it's the easy way out. And this is a full team loss, and certainly not Malcolm Subban's fault. And there's going to be, I know there's already arguing back home about whether he should have been the starter on this team all along. Well, you better call the Boston Bruins and tell them they've screwed up, that they have a first-round pick who's never going to go anywhere. Quite frankly, Chris, the goaltending talk kind of bothers me at this tournament. So Canada hasn't won gold, won't win gold for four consecutive years now, but if you break down each tournament, there's a lot more going on here than just goaltending. There are some good countries out there that play hockey
yeah.
quite well, too, and
yeah.
people tend to forget that.
Yeah, and we saw that today with the Americans.
Yeah.
They were full value for the victory, and it should be a good gold medal game. Now, as Sweden will try and go for its second straight gold medal here at the World Junior Championships. You can follow everything that's going on here from UEFA on the Sun websites. For Terry Koshin, I'm Chris Stevenson for the QMI agency in Ufa, Russia.